Good morning.
Where do we go? Nobody knows. I've got a say. That's a serious heater, Tanya. God give me style and give me grace. God put a smile upon my face.
It's 7:30. I'll probably give a couple more minutes just because my experience is with anything that we log on to, we really wait till the last minute to get there. And then there's usually some kind of a technical issue too. And so we'll just give it a second. Good morning, Roger. Is our volume good? It's good, okay. Good morning, Ash. Good morning, Andrea.
Morning.
I'm going to let you go ahead and get set up for meditation. And I'm just going to stand right here for a second and make sure we don't have any other people logging on. And really, you are mostly very practiced at taking a meditation seat, but it is the asana of the meditation, sit in a firm foundation where you feel rooted into your bones. Engage in your breath and just breathe it in and out. Like, you're not gonna control your breath. You just want your breath to be flowing. And you'll wanna, as you're pressing down into the bones on the floor, the earth, the mat, the block, you'll want to lift your shoulders up and pull them back and really expand. Like, you're expanding the upper back and the chest, and you're feeling firm foundation support in the seat. And here you breathe in and out. Allowing your body to settle into your space. creating ease in your facial expression. And creating focus. Focus of your mind on your breath and on your body. And with that, we basically just explained many of the pillars of Bhakti Yoga, your foundation, your core, your breath, your drishti, your focus. And your focus right now, your drishti, is probably behind your eyelids, could be focused on one spot. And you have to be diligent and active in creating that. There's discipline and also ease. And you connect in your breath, your focus. You connect it into the body, the sensations in your body, the energy in your seat, the length in your spine, the natural expansion, contraction in your chest. And then you connect into your space, your mat, your environment. Any sounds. And even any distractions. When you notice there's a distraction and there may be few or none or a lot, you just see them for what they are and you come right back to your focus, your drishti, your breath, your foundation, the connection of your seat, and you recreate over and over again. There's never a judgment when a distraction takes you out. You just see it and come back. And just be in your space with your breath and with our community. Allow the practice of your meditation to feel easy. And sometimes you can find a quality of like regeneration, like it's energizing you in a simple way. Take 5 deeper breaths. Draw your hands to your heart center. Thumbs to your forehead. Namaste. And welcome again. Welcome, Heidi and Shannon. Heidi, I can't see you. You may not want to be seen, but just so you know, I can't see you. And then let's go to child's pose. Start in child's pose. And do child's pose that's full of energy. So what I'm looking for in you is energy pressing down in your hands and lifting your arm bones up. Seat rooting back. Expansion in your breath. You're going to connect into breath and connect into the earth. Three breaths in and out. And in and out. Full breath in, reach a little further, settle back a little deeper, empty it out, and downward facing dog. Yeah, move around a little bit in your down dog. And then create this foundation. Your foundation is your hands, your feet, and your pelvis. So press down. Look at your feet, draw them right out of your own hips, right? So not too wide, not too narrow. It's like a place of power, really. You'll feel really stable there. You want to create that. And notice with the energy rooting into your hands and your feet, you have more space to breathe. Maybe a little more bend in your elbows, some of you. Yeah, nice. You heard me. Good. And deepen your breath. Nice. And just let the head be heavy. Let it drop down. So in this pose, a neutral neck actually means just a head dropping straight down. Inhale and breathe out. Walk your hands back to ragdoll. So you'll be at the back of your mat. You'll take your feet out a little wider than your own pelvis, maybe shoulder width, and drop down. And create a sway side to side. There's a lot of fixing happening. Is my sound okay? Is it me? Do I need to do something? I'm okay. It's just you. Then come into the practice now. I miss high fives and hugs from y'all, just so you know. And breathe. Nice. Yeah, sometimes we have to let go of the fixing. It's not going to be perfect. It's okay. It's perfect for where you are right now. You want to disrupt the thought of having to fix something. Drop your hands and heel toe your feet in slightly. Lift and lengthen your spine. And then fold down. And then lift and lengthen your spine again. And drop down. Rise all the way up to extended mountain. And bring your hands to your heart. I'm going to invite you to do an om with me. Take a big breath in. Ah. Breathe in and reach up. Breathe out, fold forward. Expand, lift and lengthen your spine. And then step it forward to downward facing dog. Take a full breath in. Breathe it out. Step your feet to your hands. Lengthen. Bow. All the way up, extended mountain. Fold all the way down, breathe out. Lift and lengthen. And go to low push-up. Upward dog, shoulders go back. Downward dog, breathe out. In breath. Out breath, step forward, jump forward. Lengthen your spine. Stay with breath, fold. Rise all the way up, extended mountain, straight to the sky. Fold forward, breathe out. Lift and lengthen, chaturanga. Upward dog, downward dog. Inhale. Empty your air, step or jump forward. Lengthen the spine, inhale. Fold to breathe out. Inhale to rise. Fold down. Lift and lengthen. And chaturanga. Upward dog. Downward dog. Breath in. Breathe out. Step or jump. Lift and lengthen. Fold. All the way up, extended mountain. Press through your feet. Fold forward, breathe out. Lengthen your spine, root in your feet. Chaturanga. You're going to have energy in both feet, both hands, in the pelvis. Up dog. Down dog, breathe out. Nice. And breathe. Lift your right leg up. Bend and stack and open your hips. Then straighten your right leg. Walk your hands back and gently open in half moon. Breathe. Take your right hand down. Walk your hands back forward. You're going to square your pelvis again, square your hips. You're going to be in the three-legged dog or right leg down. Lift your left leg up and bend, stack, and open. So you're in the three-legged dog. And then you're going to gently walk your hands back, straighten your left leg first, walk your hands back and open in half moon. And just try it on. No big deal. Oh, I found a wall behind me that really made it way easier. Breathe in. And then you're going to take your left hand down, square your hips again, walk your hands back out, three-legged dog. Nice. Step your left foot forward, meet it with right, lift and lengthen. Fold. Chair. Piece here is your feet. You're going to press through your feet, start to draw your knees back, shins back in line with your ankles. And then you're going to work to get chest over pelvis, arms long, breathe in, fold forward, empty your air, lengthen your spine, chaturanga, upward dog, downward facing dog. Warrior one, right foot forward, couple breaths in the pose to find your feet. Yeah, the feet are really the key to the pelvis. You have to root through the feet to get the pelvis to square and then lift into the middle. And though you're reaching your arms up, like you're really reaching them up, using your upper back, but you're not shrugged in the shoulders. So it's a pulling up and allowing the neck to be free. Nice, Ashley. Breathe in. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Downward facing dog. Left foot forward, warrior one. Yeah, and a few breaths on this side. And it may feel the same, it may feel different. You just work through it. Energy in your right heel, the back heel. Connect from your back heel to your right inner thigh, spin it back. Ujjayi, Drishti. Don't be afraid to deepen your lunge. Breathe in. Even deeper. One more breath. Deepest lunge ever. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Downward facing dog. Breathe in. And breathe out. Step or jump. Lift and lengthen. Fold. Chair, one inhale, fold, breathe out, lengthen your spine, little push up, up dog, lift the front of the pelvis, down dog, breathe out, warrior one, right foot forward, inhale, rise, and then exhale, chaturanga, up dog, downward facing dog. Left foot, warrior one. Chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog. In together. Breathe it out, step or jump forward. Lengthen intentionally, fold intentionally. Deep chair, knees over ankles. Fold forward, breathe out. Lengthen, low push up. Up dog. Down dog. Warrior one, right leg forward. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Left leg, warrior one. One inhale, rise. Chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Exhale. In breath. Out breath, step or jump. Lift and lengthen. Fold. Chair. And hold for a second. Hold the chair for a second. So what I'm looking for, like your feet, you want to really press into them. And as you press out, the outer edges of your quads will engage. Stay in, Macy. You're the one I was looking at. And then there's this quality. Heidi's laughing at us. There's this quality, right? You're sitting in and down and you're pressing out. There's this quality of your inner thighs kind of spiraling in. So it's like there's this little force field, right? So that your legs work together. You feel that? And then it takes you, then you can go deeper and stay integrated. Yeah, just like that. And then reach up and your arms are doing the same thing. Like you're pressing out, but you're pulling in. Breathe in. Fold. You got it. Thank you. Fold down. Half lift. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Warrior one, right leg forward. Same thing here, really, same thing. So as you dial in your foot, your front foot, you're getting the big toe and the little toe mount together, right? And that's kind of allowing the right thigh to pull back. So you really want to catch that, get the heel and the right thigh pulling back. Your left foot, press into the heel a lot, but also the mound of the foot. And you're gonna kind of spiral the inner left thigh back, and that brings the left hemipelvis forward. Right, so you get that and you lock it in and then reach way up, stay in, and then chaturanga, come down. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Left leg, warrior one. Spend a couple moments, same thing, doing the dialing it in from your feet. Feet to pelvis to lock. And then you get all that expansion in the chest. A little more front foot, pulling the left thigh back. Back foot spiraling, pulling right hip slightly forward, but you're pushing into the right heel. Breathe in, reach up, and then go down, chaturanga. Up dog, downward facing dog. One more sunbeam, breathe in and breathe out, step or float. Lift and lengthen, fold. Dial in the chair in one breath. And then fold it out. Keep engaged in the legs, half lift. Keep all the engagement, chaturanga. Upward dog, downward dog. Warrior one, right foot forward, breathe in, rise up. And then chaturanga. Up dog, downward facing dog. Left leg, warrior one. Chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Right leg up. Bend, stack open. Flip the dog all the way over. Breathe in. Breathe out. Energy in both feet, root down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale to down dog, pause. Right arm down, side plank. Inhale, exhale. One more, chaturanga. Upward dog, downward facing dog. Left leg up. Bend, stack open. Flip this dog. Set it up. Find some freedom. Create a big reach. Inhale. Exhale. Reach back to the ceiling. Breath in. Down dog. Breath out. Right arm down. Side plank. Stacking joints. Pressing down, nice. Visual focus down, side or up. One more breath, chaturanga. Up dog, downward facing dog. Right foot forward, crescent lunge. Expand your breath, breathe it out. Pull your right hip back, hinge forward, twist right. Ujjayi breath, and stay in. Yeah, and here there's like this, with your foot to your pelvis, press down in your right foot. You're still pulling the right hemipelvis back. And you're creating that spiral, inner thigh down, but outer thigh out. Back leg, you're just lifting through the glute, pressing through the foot. One more breath. Empty it out. Do not lift out of your lunge, warrior two. Feel good, warrior. Reverse, straighten, reach. And extended side angle lunge. You can come right in. Forearm to thigh. Right hand down to a block, your ankle. More energy in your back foot. Yeah. So there's this quality right here, like you're pressing into your right hand. You're looking for both shoulders to stack. What's common is the right shoulder to roll under and the left one to flop out. So you wanna press down to the right arm, line your shoulders up, and then you're gonna spin the chest, not the shoulders. You can take your left arm behind you for half bind. If you easily have a full bind, you can do that too. I would have to use a prop. The full bind opens your chest for three. Stay in two. Last full breath, expand your arms, inhale, chaturanga. Upward dog. Downward facing dog, empty. Let's do one more rinse cycle. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, low. Up dog. Down dog. Left foot forward, crescent lunge. Get it set. Check your feet out, rise up. Careful here to keep the right thigh bone into the pelvis. The tendency here is to kind of let it slide. Not real great for the joint. So press into your back foot, use your glutes, square it up. Hinge forward, twist left. But yeah, nice adjustment, actually. Looking for that same stacking in your shoulders. And this is a little harder to like feel, but what I try to do is press my palms together and just really pull back. And I think that's as close as I'm getting. Five. Four. Three. Stay in your lunge, two. Last full breath. Breathe it out. Stay low, it's warrior two. Staying deep in your front leg when you spin open. Then reverse your warrior. And if the straightening the leg feels good, do that. And then we come in extended side angle lunge. And you come right in to the full expression of your pose. And then use your breath to evolve it where you want to go. Keep your energy in your back foot. It will tend to want to lift up. Once you feel that your shoulders are stacked, you can do the half bind or the full bind. Two. Expand, chaturanga. Upward dog, downward facing dog. Headstand prep, forearm stand, dolphin. Three or four breaths in. Five breaths actually in the pose and then come down. So pick your choice. I'm starting with dolphin. You can work preps of these poses. About three more breaths upside down. One more breath upside down. And then gently bring your knees down, slide into a child's pose. Take a big breath in child's pose, a cleansing breath. And then come up to fully kneel for just a second. If you need a drink, grab one real quick. We'll call this a sanctioned break. And there's a way to take a break and still stay in the flow. You do that with the tools, your foundation. Right now, what's touching the earth? Breath Ujjayi at this point, deep and full. And your drishti. Your visual focus, your inner focus, your discipline. Okay, come to the top of your mat. Go to mountain. From mountain, sit into chair. It'll be an exhale. Breathe in and twist to the right. Breath in, empty. Come to center just in chair. Twist to the left. Stay in the practice, in the flow. Allow your body to adjust. Press more into your feet, more out. Maybe you have to pull your right thigh back. Maybe you don't. Creating that invisible tension between your legs. Twist a little deeper. Drishti at your palms, breathe in, fold down. Padukastasana, big toe pose. You'll take your feet out, grab your toes and fold. Three breaths. Transition to gorilla pose. You'll step on your hands. And then allow it to be a strong gorilla where you really pull your chest down, your arms go out to the sides, upper back expands, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Come off your hands. Into a crow pose, a center crow. You can choose a crow prep. Just two or three breaths to get in and set your pose. And then once we're in, we're gonna breathe for 3, 2, chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Left foot forward, warrior one. Reach up. Right arm under eagle arms. Shift your weight for warrior three, eagle arms. And then eagle. Drishti forward, tailbone down. Big breath, empty it. Extended mountain. Fold forward. Halfway lift, crow number two. 3, 2, and chaturanga, up dog, downward facing dog, right foot forward, warrior one. And with no anticipation, you're just coming to warrior one, root into both feet, Left arm under. Warrior three, eagle arms. Playing with your balance, drawing energy from feet into pelvis, lengthening your breath. Eagle. Three, two, inhale, reach up. Eagle right side. Breath in and out. Inhale, extended mountain. Eagle left side. In breath. Out breath, extended mountain. Hands by your side, Samastahiti. Standing by grace. Shannon has a partner now. That will be not distracting. Breathe in and out. With some connection between your arm and your leg, open it up to the side. Take your left hand just down by your side. Palm open. Shift your drishti left. Stay in. Three. Two. On one, come to center. Reach up. Airplane pose. You can go through the cactus arms or warrior three. Nice. Keep breathing. And airplane. And then just open your wings up and go to half moon. And on this one, you can grab your right ankle or foot and keep opening for sugar cane for three, two, big back bend, last inhale. On your exhale, foot to the earth, rise up. Samastahiti, hands by your side. Left leg up. Take it out to the left. Look right. Center, extend, airplane. Breath, and you're in the airplane. Lift your chest, root through your right foot. Keep squaring your left hip down by rolling the pinky toe toward the earth, lifting through the back of your thigh. And now take your wings out wide and just open like you're banking your airplane, open into half moon. And you can feel free to use a block if that helps you get expansion, or use the floor if that feels more stable, right? I've practiced a little bit with both and every day is a little different. And do the bind if it's there. Keep opening, drishti goes up. Three. Keep pulling right hip under left, two. Last inhale, foot goes down, exhale. All the way up extended mountain. For dancer pose, and you can use this strap if you have one. Keeps us honest. And open. First answer, just come in, establish your foundation for 3, 2, and 1. Sit it down. Left side dancer. Two more breaths in and out. Stay in, last one. And then foot down. So the discipline in the practice is if you are unstable and you fall out, you don't judge yourself for it. You just reset and come back. That's all there is. Right side dancer. This one for 5. Bend your standing knee to allow the pelvis some space to move. Three more. Instant forgiveness. Last breath. And then foot down. Right side. Left side. The other right. And I do have to do this check-in, especially with my right foot. I have to re-square it. It wants to turn out ever so slightly. And so you may check in with your feet real quick. Four. Three. Two. And one. I'm gonna do another dancer. You know, because it's fun. Right leg dancer for 7 breaths. And also there's still a lot of distraction. You see a lot of people getting caught up. We don't have a lot, but out of our people, at least half people getting caught up. So stay in the pose, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, fullest expression. Switch sides. And sometimes a do-over is necessary. Starting again, over and over. 6, 5, 4, 3, get your fullest expression, 2, last one, and foot down. Nice. Tree pose, right leg up. Hands overhead. One more ujjayi breath. Gently hands through your heart, right leg down. Left leg up, tree. Check in with your right foot. If it's anything like mine, it did its thing just then. Yeah, the pose is steady. Your gaze is forward. And then you reach your arms over your head and give this pose your full attention with drishti and breath, foundation from feet to pelvis. One more, hands to your heart, left foot down, inhale, reach up, exhale, forward fold. Last chance for crow, come right in. It's not gonna be very long, just breathe in. And out, land the pose in chaturanga. Up dog, downward facing dog. Warrior one, right leg forward, breathe in, raise up. Warrior two, into triangle pose. Shifting your right hip back and go down. Same thing with your shoulders here. It's your right shoulder. You press down on your right hand to pull the right shoulder kind of under, and the left shoulder just stacks. One more breath. You'll rise up. Let's take our left hand goes up. You're gonna do that archer bind, right arm behind you. So it looks like this with a towel. And then you're gonna fold in a straddle fold. So the left elbow is up, the right arm is wrapped. For three, two, and one. You're gonna rise up, rotate your feet for pyramid. Keep your bind and tighten it up if you can. Like if you can walk your hands closer together, do that. And then fold forward into pyramid with your archer bind. Drop it down for a full breath. And then bring it back up. Undo the bind, keep your right hand on your hip. Left arm up, reach forward. Left hand to a block, twisting triangle. Breath, keep working that. Press down into your left hand. You're pulling your left shoulder under the right. Yeah, nice, Macy. The mosquitoes must be terrible, is all I got to say. Macy and Aunt Andrea Palmer are gonna come home with typhoid fever or something. Okay, one more breath. Down dog. Once you land in down dog, you'll inhale into high plank. Exhale low. Upward facing dog, inhale. Chaturanga, low plank. Plank, and then down dog. Nice, just like that. Beautiful. And breathe in, and breathe out. Left leg forward, warrior one. Open warrior two. And you make the space first, right? Rooting into your feet, drawing into the pelvis, and then you find triangle. You can go back if that helps, or you can just reach way forward. Come in, a block on the outside of your foot is so helpful. And I do this little check-in. I glance at my feet, make sure that my front foot's at 12 o'clock. I look back, make sure my back toes are turned in. And then from there, I just build. And you build there. Press into your feet, energy into the pelvis, open. Ujjayi. Keep your head and neck neutral by drawing your head right out of your spine, ears back in line. Then come up, we're gonna go the opposite. So turn your toes in again, and now it's the right arm that will go up, left arm behind you. This one's easier for me. And then we're gonna straddle fold here. Five, two more, in and out, last breath in, empty it out, with it empty, rise up, inhale, and shift your feet for pyramid. So the left foot goes forward, right foot out, woo, really grounding into the feet, tailbone back, keep the bind, and go forward. And I'm like reaching my right elbow toward the wall in front of me. And I'm trying to keep lifting my left shoulder up. In, out. And then from the feet, rise up. Right arm extends, left hand on your hip. Reach forward, twisting triangle. Nice, one more breath. And then hands down, downward facing dog. Into high plank, low, up dog, low plank, high plank, down dog. Inhale, exhale, inhale, high plank, lower down to the floor for 3, 2, and 1. Place an ear down on the floor. And see if you can come into complete rest here. Maybe you could go into the pool bathroom. Turn the other cheek down. Full ujjayi breath. Now center your chin on the floor. And for the first locust, drive your knees like right out of your old pelvis. Keep your fingertips on the floor and press into the pelvis, feet on the floor. You're gonna lift your shoulders straight up, keep your head and neck neutral and breathe. And then add your feet. And you can point or flex. In my opinion, flexing is a little bit more glute and hamstring action. A little more supported back bend. One more breath. Just drop it to the floor, exhale. And then your yogi's choice on your next locust, come up for locust. You can do the same. You can reach your arms behind you, interlace, breathe in and out. Go as big as you can, inhale and drop down, exhale. Bend your knees for floor bow. Grab ankles, lift up. You want to maintain some shoulder integration by pulling the shoulders up and back instead of just allowing that roll. 3, 2, last inhale and down. One more floor bow. Bend your knees, catch your ankles and go up. 3. Last inhale and come down. Upward facing dog. Big breath. Downward facing dog. Knees down, camel pose, Ustrasana. Integrate a block, you know, between your knees or ankles is a really good tool. I don't want you to get in the habit of like really just squeezing the inner thighs in as much as you want to create some stability. Hands to your back pockets. Aligning the pelvis right over your knees, not too far forward, really not too far back. Good, find the Goldilocks spot. One more breath. And then gently come up, have a seat, second sanction break, get a drink. Cheers. Awesome. And we'll do one more camel. Get your drink, let your body kind of feel the foundation and the length and calm the breath. And then press yourself up. Create your space the way you like and open it into camel. Three, two, last inhale, do a lion's breath. Big breath in. And then gently come up. Come straight to your back for bridge. And sometimes there's a lot of setup. Just come into bridge. If you're doing a supported bridge through the rest of the back bends, that's cool. Go ahead and get your blocks and set them up for that. Otherwise, you're using full-on thigh energy and pelvis and energy from your feet to lift up. Two. Last big breath. And gently drop down. Good. Now breathe in. And breathe out. Press down. And go back up into bridge. Add your arms for wheel. Tuck your chin and come down or stay up. If you come down, you take a breath, root in your feet, go back up bridge, and then add arms for wheel. Stay up or come down. If you're holding bridge, that's cool. And if you're down, go back up bridge. Two wheel. This is the last one. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, all the way down. Take a breath, maybe just let your knees drop in that release pose. And then when you feel ready, it's Supta, butterfly pose, soles of your feet together, knees out. Let your arms rest where it's natural for them to rest. And eyes can shut down for a breath or two. And bring your knees into your chest. Give them a squeeze. Roll up into your own legs and really squeeze and hug in. Then extend your legs to the ceiling. Interlace hands behind our head. And just pulse up. 10, 9, 8, 7. Drawing your ribs to your pelvis. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold it up. And hold it up really tight. Lower your right leg down. Switch legs. Switch. Switch. Keep lifting. Switch. Switch. Keep lifting. Switch. 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 Take them up. Bend your knees at a right angle. Keep your legs stable and just rotate. Right shoulder, right elbow and shoulder to left knee, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center. Five, four, three, two, one, Navasana, boat. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So do what you need to do to get as long and strong in the boat, and then play with really getting into the belly. Three, two, one, rock and roll. On the second or third rock and roll, downward facing dog. And then half pigeon, right side. Yeah, lots of good variations. Macy found a friend. Yeah, if you can, let your body settle into the pose. Five breaths from here. Now, if you're prone and you're half pigeon, I think most of you are, press yourself up. Just press into your fingertips and lengthen the spine. See if you can get a little different stretch in both hips for 3, 2, and 1. And then press through your hands, downward facing dog. Left leg forward, half pigeon. Intentionally setting this pose up too so that you can get the most out of it. The most opening, the left glutes, the right front of the thigh. 5 breaths from here. Press into your hands and come up again for that bigger stretch. So I keep my back toes turned under always. It keeps me square in my pelvis. And then I'm just gonna press down, open a little more in the chest, a little more in the low front belly, breathe in and out. Bring your right foot around for double pigeon, right leg around. Set it up carefully, both hip bones firmly planted. You can use blocks for props in a lot of places. I put one under my right foot, but you can put it under your right thigh or under your seat. Once you get in, you stay in with breath. Gently fold a little forward, even if you don't fold all the way down. And see if you can let go of some of the tension in the shoulders and come back. Gently come up. You're gonna grab your feet and come into closed boat, Navasana. Breathe. Right thigh comes down, left leg crosses over, double pigeon. To set it up. Stay in with breath for 3. Go a little deeper if you can. Fold. 2. And last full breath, really hug in. And then come up. Let's do a few breath frog. So you can turn on your mat. If frog is just really not in your practice, you can choose to do a longer happy baby. I'm just gonna set up my knees outside of my, coming right out of my hips, toes turned out. And just gently come in. And really just about 15 breaths. So it's not going to be a long, long frog. Just enough to kind of complete the hip opening and the releasing section. And the practice here is of letting go over and over again. Let go of the tension in your neck and shoulders. Let go of tension in your jaw. We're about halfway there. If you need to turn your head the other direction. Last four breaths. Last two for complete release. And then gently, you'll just come out of your pose. You can come forward on your mat and bring your legs together. Come to your seat. Extend your legs out. You'll bring your right foot into your left thigh. Reach up and fold over your left leg. Trying to find more space in your low back. Bend your left knee and really pull yourself in. Press the right outer thigh down. And gently come up. And switch sides. Take the right leg out, bring your left foot in. Shift your body, get firmly planted, and then fold. And the same thing, you'll bend your right knee a little bit, working to find more space in the low back. And press your left thigh, left hip bone down. Expansive breath. Gently come up, extend both legs. Root both sits bones down as you reach up with bent knees and fold forward. Stay in breath. Let the head drop. And release your feet. Walk your hands behind you and come into reverse plank or tabletop. Tabletop has bent knees. Either one, the head and neck drops back. You can also extend your legs straight. Working toward the bottoms of the feet to hit the floor. Breath in and out. Tuck your chin down. Fish pose. Take your hands underneath your seat and your knees. Create a platform and then press into your elbows, head drops back. For 3, 2, and come out. We have one more inversion. You can choose legs up the wall or shoulder stand unless there's something else you're really wanting to do. I'll just demo the shoulder stand. I'm gonna work my hips right over my shoulders as much as I can in my body. Support my low back with my hands. Reach up. 5 breaths. So if you're choosing something more powerful, you wanna hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. Last breath, and then gently, nice work, Tanya. You'll go to plow if you're in the shoulder stand, taking your legs behind you. You can keep your hands supporting your back unless your hip feet touch the floor, and then you can get a little shoulder rinse if they do. Knees to ears. Vertebra by vertebra, rolling it out, the happy baby. If you did another inversion, you can just meet us in the happy baby. Remember your knees to touch. You'll cross your right leg over the left and gently twist. Legs go to the left. Reach out of your right arm. Come back to center. Switch sides. Left leg over right. You can choose another version of the twist if you want. Simple knees stacked. Or you can draw your whole leg across your body. And gently come to center. Take a moment to let your arms rest by your sides. Bring your feet together for butterfly. Let it be pre-shavasana. Take a big full breath in. Open mouth. Let your eyes shut down. Let your body feel supported by the mat. And when you're ready, full shavasana. Allow the practice to settle in your body. And allow for full rest. Allow your body 5 full body breaths just right here in this pose. Acknowledge the expansion that you feel in your chest, your back from the work you've done. Maybe a little more ease in your face. And gently bring your knees to your chest. Gently come to your seat. Hands at chest center. Take a deep breath together and let it out. And thumbs to your forehead. I see you. Together, namaste. Thank you. Can you guys unmute for a second and just say hey to me?
Hi.
Hey, Ashley. So good to see you. Hi, Shannon, Andrea, Roger, Tanya, Heidi, and of course, Mimi. I love y'all. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
I'm not sure how I'm posting this video. I ran out of Zoom cloud space, so just look for it. It'll be someplace. I love y'all very much. I'll see you next week. And then Macy and I will usually do a yod on Thursday morning, and I'll post that up on a video. And sometimes I do a practice.
Now,
I don't think I'm going to do Sundays. Look at them, Shannon. I do Sunday or Saturdays. I just post it on Thursday so that people can stay. Yeah, it's not in competition, I promise. I'm very much specifically only doing the ones that aren't done. So I either do.
Oh, yeah, that's smart.
I do Saturday or Sunday's practice. I just post it on Thursday so people can follow it through. So that way, if they're doing yod every day, they have those two. Or one of them. I don't know.
What time do you do it on Saturday? Or is it just
so I record it? I record it. So Macy and I just get up and do it at 5 a.m.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Macy,
up with you at 5 a.m.
Macy is a yes person. I love you and no is not part of her vocabulary. So far she is. So far she is. And if ever she doesn't, if anybody else would like to, just give me a ring. We got you. Now we tend to do it really, I guess it's usually 6, Macy, then we do it. What do we usually do it at 6? We usually do it at 6. So if anybody would like to join that, just message me and I'll send you a link. Because it's super great. We do Shannon can't do it because she's teaching back to back, but we do the Saturday or the Sunday yod and we just record it. So it'll be there. All right, y'all. I love you so much.
Thank you. Miss you, Lord.